So you might have noticed that computers that are on the same network, like an individual home or business or school, usually have IP addresses that are similar to each other. To be more specific about it, all of the addresses on a specific network block share a particular prefix. They all start the same and only differ after some particular bit position. And computers that are on the same network block can communicate with each other without going through a router. But not all networks are the same size. So when we talk about a particular network, we have to talk not only about its network prefix, but the length of that prefix. A network with a longer prefix has less of the 32-bit address left over to distinguish particular hosts. And a network with a shorter prefix has more addresses for hosts, so it's a larger network. The network prefix length is something that has to be chosen when the network is set up, and it's usually configured by whatever process assigns addresses to the computers. For instance, if you have a network with a 24-bit prefix, that means there's 8 bits left over for the host part of addresses. We would conventionally write this as /24. For instance, 198.51.100.0/24 network block. But if the network prefix is shorter, say 22 bits, then there would be 10 bits left over for host addressing. This would be a /22 network. And you can't tell how long the prefix is just by looking at the addresses. For these addresses, either a 22 or a 24 network would be a possibility. So how many hosts can fit on one of these networks? Well, 10 bits of host address means 2 to the 10th power addresses, which would be 1024, except that the top and the bottom addresses of a network block are reserved, and the first address is usually the router. So 1021 addresses are available for hosts. Similarly, in a /24 network, there would be 256 addresses, but minus those three, there are usually about 253 addresses that remain for hosts. Now, why does this matter? Subnet misconfiguration can cause some pretty weird problems on a server network especially. Things like, one machine thinks that it can talk to another machine directly, but the other thinks that it has to talk back through a router. And that can cause very strange communications problems. Getting a good grasp of how this stuff works can save you a lot of trouble if you're ever setting up a server network.